Of the many truths to come out of the Reels docu-series, Aaron Hernandez's Killing Fields, perhaps the most startling is the admission of a convict who says that the footballer loved him, wrote letters to him, and even proposed marriage to him. The convict in question is Kyle Kennedy, aka Pure, who says that he and Hernandez were lovers in prison. Hernandez, who played for the New England Patriots as a tight end, never came out as a homosexual or bisexual man and was engaged to Shayana Jenkins. In the interview, Kennedy said that Hernandez and him first started bonding over guns and murder and robbery. Both convicts came from similar troubled neighborhoods, which apparently led them to seek out the gang life. Kennedy said that when Hernandez became a drug dealer, they also became business partners in prison, and that the ex-footballer confided some of his deepest, darkest secrets in Kennedy. According to Kennedy, Hernandez once shared a story of how he was molested as a child by a woman who was close to the family. Kennedy added, he didn't want to tell his mother in fear of whatever the consequence might be. One of the other secrets that the former footballer told Kennedy was that he was attracted to men, but that he wasn't sure he was gay. In a confession to Kennedy, Hernandez apparently said that he had to imagine being intimate with men in order to get aroused with his fiancée Jenkins, and that Hernandez had actually considered coming out in public. Talking about their relationship in prison, Kennedy said that the two would engage in oral sex once or twice a week whenever they could find the privacy. Moreover, Kennedy believed Hernandez loved him because the footballer told him that he wanted them to marry. Kennedy added, anything I ever wanted in life, he would make sure it came true. My dreams. That kid did everything for me. The investigators of the docu-series on Reels apparently also found that Hernandez wrote love letters to Kennedy while in prison. The convict even read one of the letters out on camera, which said, I just wanted to tell you this morning that I love you and you never have to question us. You told me that you didn't want to be on the block anymore. Did you really mean that? I mean, I've said way worse, so I understand, but still, it made me almost hang myself. However, Hernandez's lawyer, Jose Baez, claims that the footballer never wrote any letters to any inmates during his time in prison. Hernandez was convicted in 2015 after he was found guilty of first-degree murder of Odin Loy, who was his fiancée's sister's boyfriend. While no motive was found and the conviction came as a shock to many, Hernandez was asked to serve a life sentence with no possibility of parole. In another case, he was acquitted of the double homicide of Daniel De Abreu and Safira Furtado in 2017. But 5 days after his acquittal, Hernandez died by suicide in his jail cell. Kennedy, who was informed of Hernandez's death by a mental health worker in prison, said that the former footballer likely killed himself under the influence of drugs. He justified his stance, saying, the first thing that came to mind was he had to have taken something, done something that altered the way he was thinking, because that wasn't him. One of the possible motives noted for Hernandez killing Lloyd was that he possibly found out about the footballer's sexual orientation. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, be sure to check out all our other videos too, and don't forget to subscribe.